It's a new business with a clever play on words name, a cannabis delivery service called Duber. I'm Pam Seidel, and residents here in Liberty Village have been finding these business cards around here lately, claiming to serve an area between Dufferin and Bathurst and Queen and Lakeshore. It also promises free same-day delivery. But is it legal? You guessed it, no it's not, and according to one expert, likely never will be.
The transactions are made via text, and a special code gives you access to the wide array of menu choices along with the prices. They even offer to roll some joints for you for free. Police say don't kid yourself, they are going to enforce the law, and when it changes in mid-October, they will enforce that.
We've been very clear, and in spite of the efforts of a lot of people in the industry to suggest there's a gray area, there is no gray area. It's absolutely black and white, and if you have no legal authority to sell it, you are breaking the law.
It's completely illegal. It violates both provincial and federal laws.
Harrison Jordan is a lawyer who specializes in cannabis law. When marijuana becomes legal, the provinces will be in charge of distributing it. The former Liberal government established their plan for a provincially controlled monopoly to sell pot through the Ontario Cannabis Store, an arm of the LCBO. During the campaign, Doug Ford opened the door to the possibility of the private sector becoming involved, but since he became premier, he has said nothing concrete.
Do you foresee a service like this ever becoming legal?
I do not foresee it becoming legal. There will be delivery online, but only controlled by the Ontario Cannabis Store.
Although there are private businesses that will buy alcohol from the LCBO for customers and deliver it, Jordan says he doesn't see that extending to pot.
It's still not permitted. The law is very clear. Only the Ontario Cannabis Stores and its authorized agents can sell cannabis. I know that there's going to be individuals and enterprises trying to get around this. They've written the law so that there are barriers to those who want to start such enterprises.
I spoke to a woman from Duber on the phone today. They declined my request for an interview, but she told me that Duber's been operating for about a year, but they've been keeping pretty quiet about it, in part because she says they're hoping to avoid any copyright infringement issues with Uber. She tells me that's what happened to another pot delivery service called WeDora. They had to go offline after Foodora threatened to sue. In Liberty Village, I'm Pam Seidel, City News.